Welcome to the Old Fashioned Masonic Podcast, where we talk all things Freemason while drinking an old fashioned. I'm Brian Bird, and I'm without my partner in crime today, Russ Brown, as he's on vacation. The topic for this week's episode is generational communication. Now, when we talk about generations, we're talking, you know, your Gen X, your millennials, baby boomers, and whatnot. So we're going to dive in just a little bit deeper and talk about the communication forms that each of those generations prefer. So let's break down the generations. So first of all, you've got your traditionalists. These individuals were born between 1925 and 1945. Although we don't have a lot of them, we still have those members in our lodges. Then we have the baby boomers. That group probably gets the most hype. We talk about them a lot other than the millennials. So these individuals were born between 1946 and 1964, followed by the Gen Xers, 1965 to 1980. Then the millennials, who seem to be talked about probably as much as the baby boomers. They're from 1981. They were born between 1981 and 1995. And then you have Gen Z, or the Zoomers, which were born between 1996 and 2012. So we have some of that group entering our lodges now. So let's talk about each group and then talk about their styles of communication that they appreciate. So your traditionalist, they like an autocratic or direct leadership style. They also still like to be rewarded for a job well done, whether it's with some sort of a reward or award or accolade, or just saying, hey, good job. That generation has always chose work over family, probably post-depression learned behaviors. They prefer the in-person communication versus communication between versus phone or text. They also prefer paper communication over emails. Nothing's a shocker there, right? So let's get into the baby boomers. They like kind of that consensual, that more of a democratic style leadership. They like being rewarded with money and titles traditionally. Now, don't get caught up if you're a baby boomer or millennial. It's like, well, that's not me. Well, you know, these are studies from everywhere. Not everything's not you. I don't agree with everything that falls into my generation as well, but these are based on a lot of studies, right? So the boomers, they really have no balance in work or family. They just don't really have a good work-life balance. They're accustomed to strict, stable, and centralized hierarchies. They have embraced tech, social media, and even remote working more. A study that just came out in 2022 showed that there was a 15% increase in this group that were applying for remote work, which I found a little bit interesting. Still on the boomers, they tend to expect loyalty and respect and obedience. But to younger generations, they feel that those values need to be earned. So boomers, little bit of work to do with the younger generation. They also prefer opportunities for face-to-face communication whenever possible, but they are embracing tech a lot more. Boomers are very direct, and they like to be direct with their communications and with the communications that they receive. Along with that, the boomers, they don't think texting and surfing the web at work or lodge is even appropriate, which I think... Work, I think that's theft of time, personally. At lodge, you shouldn't be doing that. You're there for something totally different. What is interesting, that 88% of this group say the majority of texting and surfing the web in the workplace is a no-no. So kind of interesting. They're very old school. So if any of this younger generation's caught on their phone, it's probably a baby boomer that has kind of jumped their butt about that, right? The Gen Xers, 65 to 80, they like to be led on the fly. I don't know that I agree with that as a Gen Xer, but you know what? I'm not going to agree with everything. They're internally motivated, no rewards needed. That matches me all day. I could care less about accolades and awards. They got a pretty good work-life balance. They prefer phone calls over text. I'm still in agreement so far. While our generation, we're not digital natives, Gen Xers, their employee, the Gen Xer employees are just as likely to be comfortable with technology in the workplace. So by all that so far, this group has a critical role in leadership right now, just kind of their age range. There are a lot of mid to upper level managers. They have a lot of direct reports. They stay with their company traditionally a lot longer and they take on heavier workloads. They stay in the companies way longer than the millennials. They also prefer coaching from an outside consultant or trainer rather than their own managers. So I don't know if there's a trust issue going on there or if they maybe feel like their older managers or younger managers just don't know what they're talking about, right? The Gen Xers are still, they're pretty tech savvy and direct. 20% of them use their smartphone as their major source of internet access. My gut says that that number might be low, but this is a 2022 study. What's interesting is this group is also less app friendly than millennials and the Zoomers, which we'll talk about later. Having been indoctrinated into the desktop versions of web, so they're still not quite onto the apps. I kind of buy that a little bit. I'm slowly getting over to apps because any of the new computers that you buy now, the 10 and 11 softwares, it's all app driven. So I think I agree so far. The millennials, the 81 through 95, they like to lead now. So I have children in this generation and they want to be in charge now. They like to be rewarded with meaningful work. They're not super accolade driven, but if they're doing something, it needs to be meaningful with their time. They've got a really good work-life balance. They're looking for that filter of equality. You know, some folks will call it woke, which, you know, we're not going that direction at all. They really want to make sure that everyone is rewarded for their efforts and not based on any other criteria, which, I agree. I think that's a good thing. Millennials come from an age, there was really an unstable time when they were entering the work environment with COVID about there, especially the younger side of it. So they shift jobs and even careers pretty frequently. The average tenure of a millennial is between 20 and 26 months. So they're averaging around 2 years in a position. So think about that as a lodge. If they don't feel like something's meaningful, or if they don't feel like there's some equality, could there be some problems with those millennials staying with us, right? They want to be involved in groups that embrace technology. In a recent report that was put out also in 2022, CompTIA, 71% said technology influences with whom they decide to interact with. So in general, the millennials, their mobile technology, that's what they feel that's important in their collaboration and teamwork and interaction. This group, again, I we have members in this generation and my children, they will screen you will call them, they'll look at it and say, I wonder what dad's calling for. And they'll let that go to voicemail and check it, where I just won't check a voicemail. And 75% of millennials reported that they would opt in for a text-only program. In fact, they want to receive and respond to their messages in their own time, and texting really gives them that opportunity. This same study showed that 90% of these millennials, they open the text within 3 minutes of receiving those. And a majority of the millennials are using their smartphone as the primary device for internet connectivity. So you want to be sure that you're in front of them because they're on their phones often. I mean, just think of that generation. It's like when they're bored, they go right to the phone. The Gen Z or Zoomers, 1996 to 2012, they want to be led by people that they can trust. So it's not an age thing. If they don't feel like they can trust you, they're not buying into it. They want a meaningful role within an organization. So think about that with your lodges. So, you know, don't put them on a bogus committee. If you get a Gen Z or when you get the Gen Zers, come in, put them to work and make it meaningful. They'll choose family and friends over work. So that's kind of interesting. This was a little dark, but I had to kind of dig deep into that. And I think it's because they grew up on social media more than anyone. This group has the highest rate of suicide of any of the generations, and they even haven't even lived as long. So it's kind of scary. This group prefers video over textile marketing and communication. So think about that when you're communicating with this group. Just like the millennials, they will screen your call and then check a voicemail. They actually dread talking on the phone. They interact the heaviest with social media. Again, they were born into this. Nearly 80% of this group will use social media to interact with businesses, whether they're inquiring, they're filing a complaint, or even giving praises, hence reviews. So this generation, if you're not in front of them, we're probably not keeping them, right? They like brands that court their sense of individuality. So keep that in mind as folks are coming in. They like a lot of one-on-one communication, and don't mistake that for a phone call, but direct text or direct conversations, they prefer to feel like that they're being treated as one. That they're not big fans of anything that doesn't promote their individuality, right? Again, this generation's just beginning to enter the fraternity, the Gen Z or the Zoomers. They've never known the world without technology. They expect a communication between the generations to be instantaneous and tech enabled. They don't get it that the boomers, they don't like to communicate the same way that they do. They just don't understand it. So, but it's part of understanding their communication and knowing that, right? So with all of that word salad you got regarding communication, here's how we can use some of this information to improve the communication between the generations at the lodge. So let's just talk about lodge, right? So the first thing we need to do is really educate the craft on the differences and acknowledge them. I just gave you an idea for a Masonic Ed, right? It's all of this is very easily researched. I'll put the links down in the comments section where you can do some of the research on your own. You also need to set expectations regarding the culture and the behavior as far as communications go within the lodge. Make sure that you're using different types of communications between the different generations. One size doesn't fit all. I know there's, if you'll have a young secretary, well, we posted it on Facebook. Or we sent it out in an email. Well, that covers a broad mass of them, right? But what about folks that don't check their emails or they prefer the text? So there's some other ways to kind of think about that as well. Make sure you're personalizing your approach with those certain members. It's a great job for a committee. We'll talk about the committees a little bit later. Ask, don't assume. So just because somebody falls into that generation, don't assume that they fall into all of those norms. So it's good to kind of know the makeup of your members, and you can do that on the new people as they come in and then start surveying folks as they come to lodge or your committee that you have, your retention committee that's calling members that you don't see at lodge very often. There's a lot of information that you can gather and improve your communication. You need to be willing to teach the difference in the generations, and you have to also be willing to be taught. So let's kind of talk about how to communicate a little bit more with the generations. We need to match the media with the recipient, right? So generally, the older recipients, they like more formal communications. The written memos or emails versus texts. For the millennials, you know, the social media wall posts, those work, right? Schedule phone calls. Ask whether it's an okay time to call or connect if you have to reach out. But make sure that you schedule those. Use phone. Believe it or not, people will still talk on the phone, and especially your traditionalists and your boomers, right? When you're matching the media to a message, make sure it's very simple. Simple items such as setting up a meeting. Use your email for more complicated messages. An email shouldn't be 1,000 characters. Know when to use the different types of media. And don't try to be too concise where you're going to throw it on a text or on social media where you lose some of the content. When you do your emails, make sure they're professional, spell check it, proof it, run, have some folks run some eyes over that, right? The other thing, this is kind of go back to talking, right? The original social media, sitting around a campfire talking. Lodge was the original social media before we have all of the other distractions. Use small talk to kind of facilitate some of our relationships. You see members in Lodge, go up and talk to them. Baby boomers, just so you know, they prefer to talk about work. Gen Xers, they prefer to talk about social life or work. Your millennials will always choose to talk about social life, kind of what's going on, what they're involved in. So try to keep that in mind when you're interacting with these folks and their conversations. So it's not just catered. You're not just having one blanket elevator pitch to the same folks, right? So understand the difference in your generations. The feedback that you get once you put your committees to work or you do a Masonic Ed and you get some feedback, make sure you're using that wisely. Don't overdo your feedback. For example, with baby boomers, be sure to kind of show them some respect that they're not necessarily the old guys. Gen Xers, they're happy to be challenged and they'd like that direct communication as well. Your millennials, they need a lot more feedback, but in asking for it, they should consider what's feasible and productive. So they're going to ask for some feedback, but when you give it to them, make sure it's something that's productive feedback and might be a way to stimulate their involvement. Above all, we have to remember to be kind. All the generations, time is probably the most precious commodity out there. And everyone wants to make sure that they're being valued, their time's being valued. At Lodge, you know, the future's likely to include five generations. The new generation that we have now in Lodge, the generation that are being born today that we haven't even seen in Lodge yet, they're expected to live to 100 years old. So we need to think that through. We need to be kind to the younger folks if we want them to join. We don't want to be the old crotchety guys. And by doing that, we can practice our better communication across the generations, and it can be a lot more important, right? A lot more meaningful. So to kind of summarize all of this, right? You need to understand your lodge. Pull your reports off of Maury. Know who you're dealing with and act accordingly. You may be able to pull different generations in. You know, so pull the old Excel spreadsheet out and sort it by oldest to youngest or youngest to oldest, but know what you're going on. If you don't have a communications committee, you need to have one like yesterday, and it should be a very active committee, probably one of your most active, and have a representation of all generations. Again, they know how to speak each other's language, so you need to have at least one from each generation on this committee, and they can take the community. So if you deliver a message, right, you want X message out, they can deliver it to their groups, right? Masonic Ed. Make sure your Masonic Ed is meaningful, it's relative, and it's concise. Again, all the generations value their time, and they want to make sure that their time's being utilized properly, right? Masonic education does not have to be what you think. It can be disguised in forms of games, activities, a rusty nail degree, and it doesn't have to be just Masonic. For example, this topic right here, which is about generational communication, as you would think, oh, this isn't Masonic. It's certainly a Masonic education piece because it helps your lodge. So you would be surprised what kind of topics that you could consider as a great Masonic Ed piece. So think that through. It doesn't have to be your great-grandfather's Masonic Ed. Back to communications. Newsletters, they're important. And for the masses, when you generate the newsletters, they're done in some sort of electronic format. And a majority of those can be put on your website, can put on social media, or be emailed out. Also, have a print version ready and send to those that you know that is important to them. It just might be that piece that brings them back to Lodge, right? Your degree work, same with the newsletters. You might also include personalized text to those, especially your Zoomers, your Gen Zs that want to feel needed and invited personally. You can run a text group that it's actually a mass text, but it looks like it's an individual text, just like you can do on emails. At the end of the day, people want to feel like they're included. And if you can hide a mask email or hide a mass text where it looks a little more individual, do it. Because at the end of the day, you want to get the activity and the involvement in your lodge improved. And what's the best way to kill a lodge? Poor communication. What's the best way to set your lodge in the upward trajectory back again? Is knowing how the different generations communicate and how to communicate to them. So thanks for watching the Old Fashioned Masonic Podcast. I hope that you found this topic interesting and enlightening. We'll have in the comments section, we'll have some of the links for some of our research. Please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. We really don't do that on the podcast, promote that as much, but we would really love your assistance. Thank you.